Hello, I'm Matt Cook. In this video, we're taking a closer look at Google Trends. It's a tool designed for people to see what the world is searching for, a chance to compare specific terms and see what is trending. So let's take a look. Google Trends is a great tool for journalists. It can help you find story ideas, help you follow the search interests of different topics, and see the kinds of queries people want answers to around a range of news stories. You can also go back in time to explore search interests from 2004 right the way up to within the last minute. Google Trends can help you find story ideas by showing you what topics are being searched for the most. You can also use Google Trends to track the popularity of different topics over time. This can help you see how people's interests are changing, and it can also help you identify topics that are becoming more and more popular. When you go to trends.google.com, the first thing that you'll see is a search box with examples of recently trending searches from around the world. You'll also see the Deeper Dive and the Made with Trends section. Deeper Dive is a series of pages that have been made by the Trends team. These examine searches around global events like Valentine's Day, big sporting tournaments, and the annual roundup, Year in Search. Made with Trends is a series of interactive articles made with leading designers using trends data, exploring topics from dreams to houseplants. Here you may find some inspiration. The final portion of this page has links to lessons and guides on how to use, understand, and explore Google Trends data. Trends also features a Trending Now tab, where you can see what searches are popular in different parts of the world. The tab has a daily trending and real-time selector. The drop-down menu allows you to select the country and see what is trending there. Journalists should be interested in the real-time search trends, as this is a reflection of what the country is looking for now. Trends can also be a helpful research tool. Using the Explore tab, you can look at the historic interest of any search term, phrase, or word. When you type in a phrase, for instance, umbrella, you will see a number of options appear. The first is search term. This will return searches just for the term umbrella. However, you'll also see the word umbrella with the word topic written in the description. If at this point you are searching for a name or a brand or a specific place, you'll see the description can be even more helpful. This is also a topic. Topics are generally considered to be much more reliable for Google Trends data. They pull in the exact phrase, as well as misspellings, acronyms, and of course they cover all languages. You can also add another search term to allow you to compare like for like. I'll type in raincoat, and I'll select the one that has a topic to describe the term accurately, such as garment. This builds a graph which allows you to see the two terms compared. You can now add several other terms too, building a graph for a specific location and a specific time frame. When you get your results, no matter what the time frame you pick, 4 hours or 5 years, the graph will always have a top point of 100. Everything is anonymized. The numbers on the graph don't represent absolute search volume. The graph is normalized and presented on a scale from 0 to 100, where each point on the graph is divided by the highest point, or 100. Often it can be interesting to see which region is most interested in a topic, and you can see that in the Related Queries box. Related queries can show you the top and rising terms associated with any topic or trending story. You can now see how a search term has changed over time. You can look at worldwide, national, and in some cases, even city regions. Once you've got a graph you're happy with, you can choose to download the data into a spreadsheet, or you can embed the visual onto your own website or blog. If you're using these options, we'll ask you to source Google Trends somewhere in your copy or underneath. Finally, if you're a journalist, you can stay in touch with the Google Trends team with their regular newsletter. Sign up on the front page of the Google Trends website. So, what are you waiting for? Take a look at Google Trends. You can find more information about the tool and a range of other guides to help you on our website. Google also provides in-depth coaching for groups of news organizations through our labs. You can learn more and apply on our website, g.co/newsinitiative. Thank you, and please send us any questions or feedback at contactgni@google.com.